Black History Month. You see, Michelle, she celebrates the full month, and, you know, I celebrate half. My father was a black man from Kenya, and my mother was a white woman from Kansas. So, yes, my mother loved a black man, and no, she was not a Kardashian.
Thank you. Did you just laugh or cringe at what you heard? This Obama impersonator was cut off at the Republican Leadership Conference Saturday because his act, organizers say, was getting inappropriate. So, was it the right call here to talk about a comedian? Dean Obeidallah joins me. Dean, listen, before I show you this clip.
Yes.
I thought that was funny.
I agree it's funny. And in a comedy club, it's completely fine. There's nothing at all wrong with it. It's the setting, frankly. He's performing at the Republican National Leadership Committee, predominantly, if not all, white people. And he's making black jokes as the former speaker, spokesman for the Republican National Committee said. He goes, why do we have no black people in our organization? We have a black impersonator doing black jokes.
All right, so if he had done those jokes in front of a black crowd, it would have been okay.
Fine. If he had done that in a comedy club, fine. It's the setting that makes it wrong. You know what the rest of his jokes...
That's not hypocritical? I mean, why? What?
Because that's the clip that's getting played in the media. That's the message going out.
So they should have been more aware of who the crowd was. Is that what you're saying?
They knew who their crowd was. They knew every joke is going to do. It was completely choreographed. They had photo for photo for every joke.
So funny isn't funny?
I think when you're looking at the audience, that's the question. I mean, are you going to put on a minstrel show? And this comes... It's not a minstrel show, but it's not far from that. We're having a guy playing a black guy. He's not in blackface, but doing and talking about race and making jokes about it. Do jokes about real substantive issues. Do jokes about the economy. Do jokes about President Obama having a problem with the teleprompter. Those are accurate. Those are fine.
Yeah, listen, I'm not going to give my opinion here, but on that joke, I thought it was fairly funny.
I agree. I think it's funny.
But you don't see the crowd. So,
it's
you know, I'll take you at your word. All right. Listen, you were here. You spoke to Pete Dominic.
Yes.
You know what Pete says. Sirius XM radio host Pete Dominic said that the impersonator should have stayed on stage, but he gets why organizers pushed him off. Listen.
They put him on there. The jokes are funny. The performance is excellent. But it's the place, Don. It's the place. It's a Republican leadership conference. There's a reason why over 80% of black people vote Democrat.
Okay.
Excellent. It's a good point by Pete. One of many by the smart Pete Dominic. But here's the truth. He was not cut off from making those jokes. If you watch a tape, he was cut off 10 minutes later when he started making fun of Republicans.
That was the problem.
He started talking about Romney. He said Pawlenty. When he mentioned Michelle Bachmann, they cut him off and shut his microphone off. Mm-hmm. This is the party that says we don't want regulations, I guess, except when you're making fun of us, we're going to censor you.
Okay.
What kind of message is that sending? That's ridiculous to me. They knew the jokes he was going to say. This is a corporate event. I've done these.
All right. We have another clip, and then you and I will talk about
it. Sure.
Now the Donald. Remember him? Yeah, he chose not to run as a Republican, but he's now threatening to run as an independent. But the only thing running independent of Donald Trump is his hair.
All right, that one was funny too, yeah. They're supposed to be edgy.
Reggie, that wasn't edgy, but that's a standard joke. I've done the same joke. Reggie has done a very good job. He's a funny comedian. I don't know him personally. He did a good job. He did what they asked of him. All of a sudden, the crowd turned on the event when they started making fun of Republicans. Their skin was too thin. They didn't like it.
All right, I've got to ask you this. I have to ask you this. And listen, this is just a question for the people at home, because anytime I ask something about an African-American president and I'm critical, all of a sudden I'm not black, just so you know that, right? People want to take my black card.
Sorry about that.
But I have to ask the questions about any president, regardless of the color.
Sure.
Do you think we are too sensitive because the president is black? And I've heard comedians, and I've heard people who believe in free speech, who, you know, most of us, this is free speech, this is comedy, we should not be so thin-skinned. The president, after all, is a black man. So it's not a minstrel show, there's a black man up there dressed like the president doing a funny joke.
You can absolutely say whatever you want as a comedian. The question is there going to be a backlash or not? This should not be directed at Reggie. Reggie had every right to say that. They knew his jokes. He did a great job, Reggie. But the truth is, they stopped him before. I feel bad for him as a comedian. He was probably building to a Michelle Bachmann joke. I want to hear. Probably was going to close with Sarah Palin. She's comedy gold.
Yeah.
So I feel bad for Reggie. He was going to close big. They cut him off because they didn't like him making fun of Republicans.
Yeah.
That's not the message you want to send.
Listen, there are a lot of Republicans and Democrats and politicians who really, you don't really need a comedian to do them.
No, they're great. They're never funny. I agree.
Already this helps. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
We appreciate it, Dean.
Thanks.
You know, I want to show you this.